appetizer, even like a main course if you have enough of them. I think they're more
of anything can be a main course if you have enough of them. What's up, guys? It's Kat and Dev from Two Market Girls. Welcome to a vegan recipe. If you're new here, we like to make delicious vegan food, and today we're making pies for your hens.
Again.
We like them.
I don't think we've made a normal sized pie yet.
That's no fun.
Yeah, I really just like the portability of hand pies.
Pies to go.
Try bringing a slice of pie somewhere. It's difficult. It gets messy. People stare at you.
In just 30 minutes, you can have pies to go.
Okay, what kind of hand pies did we make, Devin?
Veggie.
Yeah, so they're savory hand pies this time. So we kind of did like a chicken pot pie filling without the chicken.
Hold the chicken.
Yeah. And they're so delicious, and look how cute they are.
Aww. Should we go make them?
Probably. Do we have anything else to say? Probably not.
Probably not.
All right. We're gonna start by making our dough for our veggie hand pies. We're gonna do that by combining 3.5 cups of all-purpose flour to a food processor, along with 2/3 cup plus 2 tablespoons of butter. You're going to pulse that a couple times just so the butter's incorporated with the flour a little bit. You want it to have kind of large chunks. Then you're gonna add 2 teaspoons of baking powder along with a nice generous pinch of salt and pulse that again until it all gets mixed in there. And then lastly, we are going to add 2/3 cup plus 4 tablespoons of ice cold water. Start with 2/3 cup first, and if it doesn't come together, then slowly add 1 tablespoon of water at a time until you get the right consistency. You want a soft and together dough. Then you're gonna wrap that with saran wrap and put it in the fridge to chill for at least an hour. To prep your veggie hand pie filling, you're gonna start off by dicing 1/2 white onion and adding that to a large bowl along with 2 diced carrots and 1 cup of diced mushrooms. For this recipe, we're using dehydrated mushrooms because it gives it a nice meaty texture and a really good mushroom flavor in it. So you're gonna wanna make sure to use dehydrated mushrooms. To rehydrate them, all you need to do is soak them in boiling water for about 10 to 15 minutes or until they're nice and soft. But don't throw that liquid away because we're going to use that mushroom broth that came out of those dehydrated mushrooms for the recipe later. Then we are going to pan fry our vegetables that we just chopped up in about 1 tablespoon of oil. Add those to a pan and put a lid on them so that they steam so that the carrots cook along with the onion and the mushrooms. Once the carrots are nice and soft, you're gonna add about 1 cup of frozen peas and 1 cup of frozen corn and mix that all in together. Then you're gonna wanna add in 1 tablespoon of garlic powder, 1 tablespoon of smoked paprika, and 1/2 cup of freshly chopped parsley. Mix that all together so that it's all incorporated. Then you want to push it all out to the side so that it's kind of like a donut. There's a nice hole in the middle. Then you're going to add about 1/3 cup of vegan butter to it and allow that to melt pretty thoroughly. Then you're going to add 1/4 cup of flour and mix that all together so that everything's coated in flour. Then you're going to add 1 cup of that mushroom broth that we set aside from the dehydrated mushrooms and 1/2 cup of non-dairy milk and mix it all together and toss it until it's nice and thick and creamy. Once it gets to the perfect consistency, you want to turn that heat off and just set it to the side until we're ready to fill our pies. Once the dough has fully chilled for about an hour, we're going to take it out and on a well-floured surface, we're going to roll it out till about 1/4 inch thick. We're going to use a big cookie dough cutter. We actually used tart tins. We're going to cut out round circles so that you can fold them over and make like half moon shapes. It doesn't matter what size you want, but we recommend some pretty big ones because you won't get a lot of filling in any of the small ones. Once you have rolled all those out and you have your shapes cut out, you're just gonna scoop in some of your filling, about 1 to 2 tablespoons per hand pie, depending on the size that you chose to make them. You should get 20 hand pies out of this, and you will have leftover filling, which is awesome because you can use it to make a delicious shepherd's pie. To close your hand pies, you're just gonna drizzle some water around the edge of the dough and push them firmly with your fingers. And then using a fork, you're just going to press it into the edge so that you get more of a seal so that none of those delicious flavors seep out during baking. Lastly, in order to avoid exploding hand pies, you want to stab the tops of each hand pie so that they have some air holes, ventilation holes, so that the steam can come out. And finally, we are going to bake those in an oven preheated to 400 degrees Fahrenheit for about 20 minutes. If yours aren't a nice golden brown color, bake them for about 1 to 2 minutes longer, but you don't want to go much past the 20 minute marker.
Don't those look easy to take on the go?
Yeah, and they're a lovely spring appetizer, main course type thing. They're really good because they have so many veggies packed inside, and the dehydrated mushrooms are key for like a nice meaty texture and a delicious mushroom flavor.
You know how we feel about dehydrated mushrooms.
Buy them.
We like them.
Okay, should we try them?
Eating time.
Should I just bite into the middle of it? Ready? Mmm. That's so good. Look how good it looks inside. It kind of looks like a chicken pot pie filling.
Mm-hmm. No, it really does.
Guys, these are so good.
The dough is on point.
Yeah, I expect these to be pizza-fied.
Oh yeah, we're using this dough again.
Oh, for sure. The dough is really good. You could add so many different flavors in here. Mm-hmm. We mentioned it before, these could so easily be meal prepped. We're eating them cold right now.
It tastes great.
Make these at the beginning of the week and they're a nice little addition to your lunch every day. It'd be so good. And these make a lot. They make like 20, so.
It's so easy to make a lot of the filling too.
Mm-hmm. And the filling you'll have left over, like I mentioned before. Mm-hmm. So you can make like 2 meals out of this recipe. Just add some mashed potatoes on top of those and you got a good shepherd's pie.
Mm. Love it. Mm-hmm. I like that the dough kind of feels like a treat, but then you're eating all these veggies, so it doesn't feel
that unhealthy.
Yeah.
Yeah. Dough is really good.
I feel good about this.
Me too. If you want to try this recipe for yourself, the recipe link is down below, as always. And if you do, be sure to share some pictures with us, because we love to see them. Also, this is waiting to be customized. It's literally a pocket. It's a vessel to be carry something in.
We've created a very good vessel
so
to
If you change it up in any way, be sure to let us know. It would be cool to see what you guys do with it. I feel like some curry powder in it would be so good. Mm. Right? Or some taco seasonings. Mm. Oh. Guys, just make something delicious with this and share it with us.
In the comments below, tell us what you think would go really great in this pocket.
In this pocket, right here, this one.
Oh my God, could you make a breakfast pocket?
Oh, absolutely.
Oh, absolutely.
Should we do a pocket challenge? Let us know if you'd like us to have a pocket challenge.
Okay, clearly we've talked enough about stuffing these pockets with things. Well, let's just remind you that the recipe is in the description, as well as a link to our podcast and our newsletter so that you can stay up to date on everything we're doing, all the fun stuff. Anything that we used in this recipe is also linked below, equipment or whatevs. Whatevs.
Whatevs.
Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss any more pocket action and other vegan recipes and whatever Wednesdays, every other Wednesday.
I don't like the term pocket action.
Pocket action. That's all?
Yeah.
Cool.
Not.
Yep, that's all. Finger guns.
Things.
I don't know. I think that's all for this video. We talked enough about stuffing pockets, so we should probably just tell you to head down to the
la 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 la